Hey, what's up? It's Chris from Brooker Films, and in today's video, I'm going to talk all about the orbiting hyperlapse. So let's waste no time and let's get into it. The orbiting hyperlapse is a time-lapse that travels around a person. All that you need to complete this effect is a friend and a digital SLR camera. But if you wanted to combine long exposure photography with your orbiting hyperlapse, then you would need to put your camera onto a tripod in order for you to capture the custom light streaks. So once you've found your location, you want to tell your actor or your subject to completely freeze. If they're moving around and they're fidgeting, then this just is not going to work. So tell them to look the same direction, do the same motion with their arms, and just completely stand still. Now once they're standing in place, you want to go round to the side of them and frame up a specific point of them. Now for this, I use the grid lines built into the camera, and I frame up one of the top points onto the actor's head. This is a reference point, and I should be using this point to match up to the actor's head for every single photo throughout this time lapse. It's important that you do this, otherwise the hyperlapse is just gonna look a little bit too jittery and it's just not going to be a good effect. So from here, you want to take a photo, move a tiny step in the other direction, and take another photo framed up at the same point, making sure that head is in the same grid line as the first photo. Now you want to complete this process over and over and over again until you've done a complete semicircle around your talent. Now, make sure you get at least 50 photos into this sequence. 50 photos will give you a 2-second hyperlapse. So if you wanted to do a semicircle in 4 seconds, then you would need 100 still photos. So for this, you would need to increase or decrease the size of the steps that you're taking between each different photo. Now, once you've captured all of your photos, you want to go and find a different wall and you want to do the same thing again there. Once you've captured all of your shots though, you need to get these onto the computer and get them edited in Adobe Lightroom. So let's get onto the computer and let's get into that right now. Now from here in Adobe Lightroom, you want to import all of your photos. Now once they've all loaded up, you want to go over to the first image and drag that over into the Develop tab. Now when you're inside the Develop tab, you want to go through and you want to color grade this first image to make it look as cinematic as you please. For this, I'm just going to pull down the highlights, pull up the shadows a touch, pull up the exposure, pull up the vibrance, the saturation, and then increase the contrast just a touch. Now once you've done that, you want to copy this color grading so that you can paste it onto all of your other images. So go down to the button on the left, which says copy, and make sure all of these are selected. Now when they're selected, just press copy and then go back into your media tab. Select all of these and then go down to the button on the right that says synchronize settings and just press this. Now this is just gonna paste that effect onto all of your images. Now once that's complete, you can go and export all of these photos back into a JPEG format. So you want to select all of them, go down to the left and press export. Now from here, you just want to select the destination and adjust the file size of these images. Now once that's complete, you need to load up Adobe Premiere Pro and we need to import these as an image sequence. Now once we've loaded up Adobe Premiere Pro, we need to go down into the Import Media to Start tab. We want to double click, press Import, and you want to go through and find your image files. Now from here, you want to select the first image and then you want to make sure that this is selected as an image sequence. If this box is not checked, then this is only going to import one still photo and you want to import this as a video. So make sure this is selected. And now do this again for your second hyperlapse. So go into your Finder, import, and select image sequence. Now once they're both created, you can select both of them and create a new sequence from clip. Now if we play that back, it's a little bit shaky, so we need to smooth that out. So we're just gonna drop some warp stabilizer on both of these. And that's just gonna smooth that out perfectly. Now, as you can see, the aspect ratio of this sequence is 4:3, and we want to create a 16:9 sequence. So we're gonna go out to File, New, Sequence, and we're gonna make that 1920x1080. Now from here, you want to drag the other composition into your 1920x1080 composition, and just resize the image up so that it fits the screen. And that is basically it. If your video is still a little bit too shaky, then you could add another round of warp stabilizer here, but don't overdo this because you'll get a weird yellowing effect. If you enjoyed watching this video, then please do let me know in the comment section below. And don't forget to subscribe if you would like to see more videos like this one in the future. Don't forget to press the bell icon if you would like to stay updated and notified on future uploads. Thank you ever so much for watching this video. I really do truly appreciate it. I hope you're having the most amazing day today. I will see you next time. Thank you for watching.